I've worked with Inuit elders and hunters, mainly on Baffin Island in Nunavut, documenting their observations and knowledge about climate and environmental change in their part of the Arctic, and also bringing together Inuit experts with visiting scientists to make collaborative teams that look at questions and concerns around the impacts of those changes and how we can respond. Of all of the changes that people talk about with climate change, the ones that are most concerning are those related to hazards and safety. So changes in the environment that put people at risk, for example, sea ice changes where it might be not as safe to travel in certain areas, or weather patterns that have changed or are unexpected and put people at risk for ending up in unexpected storms or strong winds. Also, those changes that impact food. So changes in wildlife, or again, changes in environmental conditions that might hinder access to food. So again, changes in sea ice where people might not be able to travel to certain areas or travel as long, that allows them to get to their food sources. One of the skill sets that Inuit had when they lived a traditional life on the land was being able to predict the weather, forecasting the weather, and they would do that by observing different things in the environment, including cloud patterns and even things like animal behavior. And there are still elders today that have some of those skills, but they talk about how the weather patterns, the weather variability, has increased so much that the skills that they used to predict the weather, the methods and indicators that they used for forecasting weather, don't apply anymore. And that's put these experienced people in a position where they don't feel as comfortable offering advice, offering a forecast to hunters who might be heading out, because they might give the wrong information. And they don't want to create a situation where someone's relying on their knowledge, but it's it doesn't turn out to be true. So I've talked about this with some of the traditional forecasters, and there's an emotional reaction to that, because they used to be in a position where people would come to them for that trusted knowledge, and not being able to provide that anymore because of this big shift in weather patterns. It's really made some people feel sad, feel concerned that they aren't able to contribute in that way to their community. Another thing that elders and hunters we work with talk about is the fact that knowledge doesn't stay the same over time. It's not static, and neither is culture. And Inuit culture has been changing continuously, and it still is changing. And a lot of that has been, a lot of that change has been accelerated by the movement into communities and losing the traditional lifestyle. So elders who have traditional forecasting skills talk about the weather patterns have changed themselves, and that's their major problem, but their skills have changed as well. They're not living outside all day, every day like they used to. And also, the younger hunters who are looking for weather forecasting information and environmental information are using different tools as well. They rely on forecasts on the TV and on the radio to understand the weather conditions for that day. They look at satellite images for sea ice information. They use GPS to help them navigate. But even though all of these modern tools are available to them, there's still a role to play in that traditional knowledge. It fills a gap. It brings information that you can't get from those other sources. So there's a real interest in trying to keep these traditional skills, revive these traditional skills, and pass them on to the younger generation.